start to dig into what's happening. And some people need that kind of learning as well. So provide them actual coding examples that work, so that if they want to take that example and start to tweak it and do different things for what they're trying to work on, they'll have something that works that they can always go back to when they're troubleshooting. Live coding sessions. This doesn't have to be in person. These are actually probably best not in person. So you know, pair programming or coding together, and your screen sharing. There is a, I'm trying to think, my brain is like, oh, CodePen. There is like a payment to it, but I think that there's a feature in CodePen where you can actually like pair program together, so you can actually write together and you can both see each other's work. There's multiple ways that you can do this, but the nice thing about this is that you can allow them to contribute, and they will feel like a developer. So you're there to kind of guide them and help them talk through the paths that they want to do, but they're helping write that code, and it makes them feel like a part of your team because they're contributing. Code reviews. Code reviews are super important in all areas of life. It's really nice to have other people review your code. Maybe you missed something. Maybe there's a better way that you can do it. But it's also a really good way for you to encourage them to do something different. And why I say that, because the most important part about this is never tell them that they did something wrong. Don't say, like, you did that wrong, you shouldn't have done that. Instead, encourage them, or even ask them, like, why they did that. Maybe they don't understand the end result, or maybe they just don't know of any other way. So work through that choice with them and give them additional hints and tips to get to that same end result, maybe just a little bit more efficiently or in another way. Lead a study group. So this one's cool because you can actually help more than one person at one time. If you lead a study group, maybe you can share it on Meetup, maybe you can create some other type of like event that you can invite people to. Maybe you reach out to your local meetups to tell them it's happening, and then maybe they're willing to share it on their Meetup page. However you feel that it works, lead a study group, because the nice thing about this is that there's power in numbers. You're helping more than one person at one time. But they also have people that are also going to do that, right? So maybe like 5 people come. All of those 5 people, they might find someone else in that group that they get to know, and then all of a sudden they have like this buddy that they're also going through this kind of life transition with, and they can relate to and talk to. So it has multiple purposes. All right, so tips for being a good mentor. My voice is like, or my throat is like dying, so we'll see how long I can make this. All right, so tips for being a good mentor, or mentee, I should say. All right, so let's go back to that, because I know that wrong. So tips for being a good mentee. So if you're in here, and maybe you need a mentor, there are things that you should consider as well. So this is for anyone who's a mentee who is looking for a mentor. Set expectations. So before you kickstart your relationship, set expectations with your mentor about what you're hoping to achieve. So if you're looking for a mentor and maybe you want to learn about WordPress, maybe you're like, I know how to add content to WordPress, but I really want to know how to build a theme. Or I really want to know how to build something else, like a plugin or whatever. Tell your mentor that. Tell them what you're looking for so that they can provide you with the best information and also make sure that they're the right person for you. Maybe you're talking to a plugin developer, but you want to learn about themes, and maybe they're like, I don't really care about CSS or JavaScript. I just like PHP. Then maybe they can help you find someone else that does. Make sure that that relationship is paired well. Be respectful of their time. Like I just said that you know, as a mentor, they're all volunteers. So you want to make sure that you're very respectful of their time and use your time wisely when they tell you that they're available. Come prepared with an agenda. Oops. Oh, that's right. So use your time wisely. That kind of fills into like be respectful of their time. If you have a meeting, maybe you decide that you're going to get together once every 2 weeks at a coffee shop that's an hour long. Your mentor is probably coming in expecting to answer any questions you have. So if you don't have any questions for them or you don't tell them what you want to know, it's not their responsibility to bring content to you. It's your responsibility to tell them what you want from them, and then they can provide that information for you. So have an agenda. Maybe 1 week you're like, I really want to learn about CSS. And then the next week you're like, oh, I really want to learn about jQuery or whatever that looks like. Have an agenda so that they can help fill in that agenda for you. Mentors are volunteers. You have to remember that. Like, I personally have kids, I have a family, like, I have a lot of stuff going on. So when I have a mentor who wants wants to just like get together on a Friday night and have dinner and do whatever. I love that they want to hang out with me, but like my family wants to hang out with me too. And so I need to be wise about the choices that I make and the time that I spend with them. And so as a mentee, you need to remember that they're volunteers and they have their own life and their own jobs and their own stresses. And make sure that you make it easy for them to hang out with you and help you. So own your learning. Your mentor can provide you with great information, but you must be the one to actually use it. You need to be the one to say, I want to learn this, and I need to know this, and I'm hoping you can help me with this, and own that, and actually be responsible. So when your mentor gives you a coding tutorial about JavaScript, do it, and then come back with feedback and say, I learned something, I learned this. This was helpful because of whatever. And you're responsible for that. It's not your mentor's responsibility to make sure that you're learning. It is your responsibility to make sure that you're learning. Express your appreciation. Everyone likes to feel appreciated, and being a mentor is so rewarding anyways, but make sure they know that you appreciate them. Just tell them thank you. Tell them that you appreciate their time, and that you especially appreciate their relationship. All right, help others achieve your dreams and you will achieve yours. That's very fitting for me because helping others learn to code is so rewarding for me that I feel accomplished. I don't need to get any further in my job. Like, honestly, that's all I need to do and I feel great. And that's why I ended up at Pantheon, actually, because I teach a lot of trainings about our platform and about coding, and I get to do conferences and speak to people. And this is all things I love to do. So find what you love to do and do it. All right, so we're gonna come back to the Slido that I hinted to earlier. So if you haven't opened it already, it is sl.do, and then it is WCSD18. So I'm gonna exit out of this quickly. All right, so these are the results from the first question. In a second here, I'm gonna choose the next question here. It looks like 35% of you want to be a mentor. I just want to give every single one of you that said that a hug. Like, that makes me so incredibly happy. There are so many people in this room that want to be a mentor. And behind that, there are 24% of the people that need a mentor. So I'm going to put you all on the spot. If you have like a computer on your lap, I'm going to ask you to put it down. If you said that you want to be a mentor, can you stand up? Do it, please. It will be worth it, I promise. Okay, awesome. So look around the room for those of you sitting down and remember the people that are standing up right now. Okay, so the people that said, I need a mentor, can you please stand up? Okay, now I want you to look at each other and I want you to leave this talk and I want you to talk to each other. Don't leave and say, oh, that was really great. Don't stay sitting because you answered a question and you're scared. Do it. Talk to each other today because all of you might be able to help someone in this room with something that they want to know. And if you're all local or some of you are local, that's even better. So make sure that you all chat. All right, you guys, sit down. Thank you so much. I know it's stressful to stand up in the middle of the talk like that, but I appreciate it. Oh, you guys, like, look at this. It is like shooting out there. All right, so I'm a manager looking to implement mentorship with my team. If you said that, please stand up. That is awesome. That is so great. So if you said that you wanted to be a mentor, chat with these people. Or if you said that you are a mentor, chat with these people. You all have something that you've experienced. Maybe they know what they're looking for. Maybe there's something along that lines. All of you can chat with all of the rest of you in this room and get what you need. All right, you guys can sit down. Thank you. All right, so last one. If you are a mentor, please stand up. Just making you all move today. All right, only two of you are already mentors. I hope that after this talk that changes. If I all see you in another year and I come to work in San Diego next year, I want all of you to come and tell me that you've changed that, that you've become a mentor, or that you've implemented mentorship. You guys can sit down and thank you so much for already being mentors. All right, I'm gonna implement the next question so you guys can answer that. If I can figure it out. All right, here we go. Okay, so this one, the slides that I gave you of where to meet mentors was very opinionated and things that I've personally experienced. I want to know where some some awesome feature that looks really great in the design, but it's like, actually, to code that, it's going to be pretty inefficient. And I wanted them to know those things. I wanted them to become better web designers and know some of the things that are just kind of silly to do in, from a coding standpoint. And vice versa, they taught me about some topography things and some other really important design things that they felt passionate about, and why they gave me sometimes designs that maybe weren't super efficient to code. And it was more relatable. I could relate to why they wanted to design that. They could relate to like why it was difficult to code. And it just built a really good relationship. So no matter what you're doing, mentorship can happen inside of your jobs. There's so many more now. Internships are great. Oh, the gym. That is actually very fitting. Totally meaningful to gym. Awesome. So outside of the tips I gave you, like remember these things. These are also other places that you can start to build these relationships. All right, so this last part, we have about 15 minutes left, I think. Is that right?
15 minutes.
Okay, 5 minutes. Okay. Okay, cool. So I'm going to go through the questions that are on here. There are two questions. If you have a question, feel free to add that. And so I'm just going to start going through those questions now. Do you recommend new developers get involved with open source projects to gain experience? Absolutely, 100% yes. So WordPress, we all can contribute to WordPress. We all can contribute to Drupal or Joomla or any other open source solution that you want to work in. We all have that power. And it's hard for us to see sometimes, especially for me, it was really hard for me to realize that I could go and help. I would say that like most of my development expertise is like primarily in a WordPress instance. I would say like primarily theming, but I could like dabble in plugin development if it wasn't overly complicated. And I saw that as like a hurdle, like I saw that as an issue because I'm like, oh, WordPress is so PHP based, like how can I even help? Like I can't help with some of that stuff, like that's pretty advanced stuff. And even in the beginning, if that was how I felt, like you can answer support chats, like you can go in the forum and you can just help people that are asking questions. You can also help in different departments, there's tons of departments. One of my coworkers is on the marketing team, and he doesn't really know how to code, but he does awesome in the marketing team. So get involved with whatever you want to get involved with, and then that will start to grow. Maybe you'll start to learn PHP, and then you'll feel more more qualified to be able to contribute to the actual code base. Do you think junior level is poorly defined? Should companies adopt the term entry level to imply no experience needed? I actually do agree with that. I think that we are not doing a fabulous job about saying what a junior developer is. Based on those job descriptions, a junior developer is someone who has at least two years of experience. For me, I feel like a junior developer is someone who's very new. Maybe they do have a year of experience, maybe they have no experience. They know how to do something they need to know to do the job, right? They went through college, they did something, internship, whatever. And maybe there needs to be a more role that actually is entry level. And we all can work on that. Maybe that's something that we put some initiative in. Maybe your company tests that out. Maybe instead of calling it a junior developer, it's an entry-level web developer. And if you have feedback on that, I would love to hear it if you try it. I think the most important thing is just reiterating in your job description that you're willing to hire someone who does not have experience if they have a passion to learn and they're willing to do the things that they need to do to get to where they should be. Do you recommend someone find a mentor outside of their field or expertise? I think that you could. I think everyone has something to learn. You know, there's people who don't code. They came into my classes who did not know anything about coding at all. And then I was able to give them enough knowledge to feel comfortable talking to coders. It wasn't their ambition to actually learn how to code. They just wanted to understand. Like I had a business owner come in, and she had hired a developer to build her website. And she was starting a business, and she was putting all of her savings into starting this business. And she had no idea if she was making the right choice when she was hiring this developer. She wanted to know the basics of coding. She wanted to know what CSS was, what that word even meant. She wanted to know some of these things so that she, when she actually hired that someone and paid them a big portion of the funds that she had available to start her business, was she making the right choice? Was it a good investment? So I think it is a good idea.
We have a hard cutoff at 50 minutes, so if you want to reserve some time for questions.
Yeah, these are questions. Okay. But if anyone wants to stand up and ask a question, does anyone have a question outside of these ones? So the reason I do this is because some people are scared to ask questions. So Some people are afraid to actually raise their hand and have everyone in the room look at them when they ask that question. And I don't want there to be any hurdles or any issues with asking me a question. So I do it through this app so that everyone can feel perfectly comfortable asking a question. So we'll get through one more, and then if y'all have any more questions, I am going to be, I usually don't sit at the booth because I'm not a big booth person, but I work for Pantheon. I'll be around. I'll be chatting with people. I'll be in sessions. Like, feel free to track me now. Okay, so at what point in the developer's career should or could they start mentoring? Right away. Like, immediately. Even if you're a new developer, you might know something that someone else doesn't know. If you're a new developer, maybe you went through a code school, and you're just getting your first job. You can start to mentor people who are just going into a code school. There is someone who knows less than you. There is someone who doesn't know how to code at all. And you can actually teach them the fundamentals, like that booth, that business owner I was just chatting about. If you're like in a code school, you can talk to people like that. She just wants to know some of the fundamentals so that she knows that she's making the right choice. Anyone can be a mentor at any time, no matter what role, if you're a developer, if you're a designer, whoever you are, you can mentor someone because you know something. All right, we've got like 2 minutes. If you have a small company, how would you avoid managers being mentors? That is very hard. If you have a small company, I think that it's okay for managers to be some form of a mentor, but they just can't be the person that they ask those quote-unquote stupid questions to. Bring in someone external. They don't have to work for you, and you don't have to hire them, but maybe go out and do the things that I said about, like, finding mentors. Maybe find someone else in the industry that knows the things that you want your junior developer to know. You can offer to pay them. You can offer to give them some type of insight. Maybe they'll just do it because they want to grow their network. There are mentors out there that are willing to just do it for free because that's most of us. That's me. You might find someone outside of your company that's willing to do that if you need someone who is not a manager. All right, well, we will wrap it up. I think there was an additional question, but I can answer that later. If you want to chat afterwards, you can just go up to the happiness bar. But thank you, all of you. I'm happy that you're here, and I appreciate you all standing up on the